There's so much history here. And enjoy myself and also meet so many people. So
mom earlier this week, and I asked her what's next, and she said the two of you kind of tussle. You say 2012, that's it, and she says, oh, come on, Michael, just a few more years back and forth.
I'm down 2012. Right now, I think really over the next week it's going to be the first time where, you know, there's nothing really planned, and it's sort of my time. So I'm going to be able to relax with some friends. I have some friends in town here that I'm going to be able to catch up with. And I'm going to be able to relax a little bit. I'll be able to lay on the couch and watch TV or sleep as late as I want. You know, there's some things like that I'm really looking forward to. And I think this week I'm going to be able to do that.
At least 10,000 people showed up tonight. What do you think when you hear that?
Kind of state Baltimore, Maryland is. You know, whether, you know, what kind of state they are. You know, everyone here is so supportive of everybody, and especially sports. You know, Baltimore is such a big sports town, and you know, being able to have people like this, you know, people who are in the stands here, to be able to come out and support, you know, the welcome home of all of Baltimore's Olympians. You know, I think really just shows what kind of city we have here, and what kind of people we have in Baltimore.
What's with the facial growth?
It's just being lazy and not wanting to shave.
Would you go to the Ravens tomorrow, essentially, as a spectator, or are you doing anything?
Well, I hope it's as a spectator. As of right now, you know, I've heard of it, so I'm not really sure exactly what it is, so maybe I'll get a feel of it without it. But, you know, I'm actually, you know, really excited to go and be able to cheer on the Ravens and hope for a win. You know, I guess that's probably my number one team that I really support. No matter what time of the year it is, you know, every single game, no matter who they're playing, I'm always watching. So I'm a diehard Ravens fan, and you can guarantee all my jersey tomorrow.
Did you get to see when Baltimore, the fans were there cheering for you?
I actually saw that. I saw the clip when I was doing the game show. I got to see the clip of Ravens Stadium watching my eighth race. So. Oh, that's it. That's a pretty special thing. It's definitely pretty cool to be able to look at the TV and see that, you know, your hometown and just watch your Roger Rich at an NFL game.
I can help Columbia find the last couple of weeks in the United States. What happened there?
Not really. No, I didn't have a lot of fun. So being able to do things like SNL, being on that, you know, the late show with my being able to do some of those things, and doing the VMAs, I've been able to do so many cool things that I'm just having fun. I'm tired, but you know what? It doesn't matter. I have the opportunity to do so many amazing things, to meet so many amazing people that I can always get energy. There's never any need for energy.
How did you enjoy it?
That's what I was awesome. Being able to do that, not many actors can say they do that, I have the opportunity to do that. Being able to do that and seeing how much work really goes behind it, 8 to 12 hours every day, reading scripts, making sure the costumes are right, making sure the scenes are right, the props are right. So it's a lot of work, but it's something that I'd love to do again if I had the opportunity.
Speaking of that, was it hard to get off the Michael Phelps diet now that you haven't been swimming?
Michael Phelps' diet is definitely trimmed down a little bit. I definitely not been eating that much food, but I have been eating well, I have been eating properly, and I'm actually still trying to gain weight. I've lost weight since I've stopped swimming, so.
Now, I'm from the Eastern Shore, Maryland, so I have to ask, what's the number one thing
you missed all over the world? Well, actually, I got off a plane about 2 days ago from L.A., and the first thing I did when I got off the plane was a few friends of mine and I went and got crabs. So we went and had some crabs, just actually talked about old times, like middle school and high school. So it was a pretty cool experience.
Michael, how do you like Crescent?
What's that?
Your new place in Crescent.
I haven't really lived in my house yet. I'm just trying to get stuff situated, but I'm excited to live in the area where I am. It's a pretty good area. Surrounded by pretty good people, and looking to try to get some normality back to my life.
You gonna wear your custom made Ravens jersey tomorrow?
That's in the box.
Okay,
that's already in the box.
Two more.
In terms of the Ravens, I know you're a big fan, and also I just wanted to know if you could comment on Ray Lewis and what's his impact on Baltimore, and how would you feel if someone like that who's put a lot into the community works in Baltimore?
Ray's a monster. You know, the guy is just an absolutely amazing player. He's got a great outlook on life. And I think he's definitely a good person for Baltimore to have, for the Ravens to have. And I hope he stays around for a few more years. We definitely need him on that defense. Give up.